There's, you know, a lot of things can happen, a lot of questions that people have. I know you've done your research, your due diligence, and you deal with this all the time. So I'm going to let you dive right into what you got.
Yeah. You know, this comes up every so often, and it's something that nobody really seems to have a good take on, because, you know, it's something that I think you deal with when the question is asked, but you know, you don't have like a firm grasp of the concept. So I wanted to have a segment quickly on cesspools, because like you said, it affects really any property, any price range. The law was passed some time ago in 2007, but the operative date is whether the closing takes place on or before. There was a window, you know, of time that the state allowed people to address the cesspool situation. And so the window was until January 1st of 2016. All cesspools that are located on a property need to be replaced. The question is, when does that cesspool get replaced? Okay, so and that is really the key with the statute. The statute says within 1 year of your closing date, if you have a cesspool, you need to replace it. And so, how do you replace it? You replace it with a connection with the sewer, or do you replace it with a septic system? So it just depends on what's running along your street. If you have sewer lines, generally, a sewer connection is going to be cheaper than a new septic system. So if you want to sell a house, do you need to replace your cesspool? And so the rule is not that the seller doesn't need to replace it. If the seller replaces it, great. But the seller doesn't need to replace it. It's the trigger date is the date of the sale. Okay. Yep. Not that the seller has to do it as a result of this statute. The other thing also, which is important to note, it, you know, really affects REO properties too. So, you know, we have properties that are being sold as bank owned properties. When the bank forecloses, they don't need to comply. But when the bank sells it to a buyer, a third party buyer, now that is a trigger, and that would apply. So now the question is, how do you know that you have a cesspool or not? Well, there's you can do an inspection of your property, and typically an inspection would be between $75 and $250. Then if you needed to pump the cesspool out, it would be an additional $150 to $200 to do that. So the question that always comes up, obviously dollars and cents is what's important, is what would it cost to connect or to switch from a cesspool to a septic system, or switch from a cesspool to sewer? And I mentioned early on when I was talking that it is cheaper to connect to a sewer system. Sure. If there is a sewer system, a typical septic system would run between $10,000 and $15,000, but it can be more.
60. You could look at $30,000 to $60,000 in high, highly sensitive water areas. Like you
that's
said,
right.
If not, or, more, depending on bedrooms.
That's 100% right. That's exactly what I wanted to say. You know, that would be in a situation where you know, the CRMC has to weigh in and evaluate whether your property is close to a drinking water supply, or to a river or a pond, or, you know, so it can really be expensive, an expensive proposition.